Now, I'm sure like me and a lot of our viewers, Gary, you've been on that lighting refurb job. Maybe it's an industrial unit or an underground car park or something. You've got that existing conduit system on the ceiling. You're taking out the old inefficient magnetic ballast fluorescence and you're putting in lovely new LED strip lights to bring up the efficiency of the installation. What seems to be the first two problems that you always have with that existing conduit system?
First of all, I want to know, when I take that light fitting down and get the tape measure out, is it 600 centres?
Yep.
And then I'm thinking about the new fitting I'm going to install. They seem incredibly narrow on the back. So if I bring this one in, we can demonstrate the problem when the box is introduced, what happens then.
Yeah, absolutely. So the existing system will always have those 600 centres. This fitting doesn't have a 600 centre drilling point. It's got a drilling point at either end and in the middle, but nothing at 600. And also, as you say, when you bring that in and mount it on the back box, you can see that you've got that big old gap down the side there.
But why is that?
Well, it's basically because this type of fitting is designed with the continental European market in mind.
Okay.
And they just happen to prefer a slimline fitting over there. Absolutely nothing wrong with that. However, it doesn't take into account this, which is our kind of British conduit box. So if we were full on lecturing mode, Gaz, if we went back into a college classroom now, what would we be referring to this as?
That would be a 25mm through box.
Indeed. It's got another name as well, which is the BESA box. Now, what does that stand for?
British Electrical Standards Accessory.
Indeed it does. And how long ago did we learn that?
Oh, about 10 minutes.
Yeah, okay. So we didn't know that until we started making this video. And that is the problem, that this fitting is not designed with the BESA box in mind. And so we need a solution.
Oh, and I think I've spotted it. It's at the front here, Joe. So what we got here?
Well, here we've got the ToughLED Pro from JCC. They've come up with a solution to this problem. And to be fair, this is the upgraded version of the ToughLED original fitting from JCC. So these are both ToughLEDs from JCC. This is the ToughLED Pro, the new version. And again, looking at the back of this, you can see instantly, you've got those 600mm fixing points there and there. And you've also, when we introduce our back box, you can see that that is gonna sit on there absolutely beautifully.
I'm getting a little nervous. There's two products in front of us. It looks like one of them might be easier to install. So I'm sure you're thinking there's going to be a race. Well, there isn't going to be a race. Only me racing myself in order that we can actually prove whether one is faster to install than the other.
Absolutely. So stay tuned because this is crammed with features that make it easy to install. We managed to get excited about a weatherproof light fitting. So watch out for that. But I think we cut over to that footage and we see how you get on with that, Gary.
I'm going to win.
And we're off, Gary. So what's the first thing that you're going to do here?
I'm going to undo those clips. It can be a little bit sharp on the fingers. And they've also got a mind of their own. You unclip them, you think you can remove the lens. And of course, one of the clips always goes and grips it back again. So pop those out of the way.
Excellent. Yes, it does make it challenging to remove that sometimes. And we've got a little bit of Tony Hart action here, or Neil Buchanan for our younger viewers, or Mr. Maker for our fetal viewers.
Okay, yeah, so I've got to make sure those 600, so I'm using the original fitting to get the actual positions that I need them to be in. I'm going to measure it.
You're not confident, are you?
No, because once I've drilled this fitting, I've actually got the hole where the hole is. There's a lot more wiggle room in the original one now. The tray comes out, always find this challenging, drops back in and grips again, can always be a little concern. Not as brave as I once was, so we're going to go in and drill. I've got one shot at it. I've done my 600 centres, so hopefully this will be okay, and I'll make some conduit box lids for it to go onto.
And now we're drilling those holes in what we hope are the right positions, Gaz.
Well, I've measured it twice, so I'm pretty sure they're going to be good.
Well, that looks good on the fluorescent light, not bad.
Now to make these plates up in order to attach the fitting.
Wouldn't it be great if we didn't have to do that, though?
It would. Terrific, isn't it? It's like the lock ring's got a polarity. It might go on one way, you turn it over, it still doesn't go on, does it? So this is what's going to happen then. They're obviously going to be on the conduit and they'll be attached to the back of the light fitting in order to secure them. So get those into position.
This feels like a lot of extra work that you're having to do here, Gary, to get that light fitting mounted.
You just want to watch this process though. When I pop this in. Thank you. Don't know if they even bother. Don't need them.
And Gary engages smug mode. What's next?
Trying to get the straps on in order to hold the fitting in. They're quite stiff as well. When you push it back up, there's always a chance they'll spring out the side and you actually trap it between the cover. So I've got to be careful with those. Connections are easy as anything, so pop those in. So
still got the push fit connections there, so that's handy. Now this is the bit that always gets a bit frustrating, because if that back has malformed at all, you're in a world of pain.
Yeah, and also you worry about the clips. Will it hold in? You push one, the other one pops out. So I'm trying to get it in.
Pretty good. And now it's just a matter of getting those really irritating clips that are everywhere you want to be.
Always under, aren't they, the cover, as you're trying to put it on. The diffuser gets in the way. You think you've got them all, and then you end up circling back, and you always find the odd one you've missed. So I've got them all now, have I? Have I got more gas?
Well, I like the nice logical order you did them in anyway. That was good.
So one more there.
There we go.
Got them all.
Now you've got them all.
Count them in, count them out. And we're ready to stop the clock. I know what you're thinking. Some light fins come with already an adapter in the pack for those BESA boxes, and I've got one on the desk here. Shall we take a closer look?
Indeed, you can see that there. So this didn't come with this fitting, we've got this separately. And the idea is we can put this onto a BESA back box and then the light fitting will simply clip onto it. So that's a clever bit of kit that just screws onto, it doesn't screw onto the box there. You can see that the spacings there are different. So even having this adapter is no guarantee of being able to do that.
Okay, so that would have saved us a problem, but it didn't, so hence I had to make those plates up. But to get a true reflection, if it is quicker or not, we'll go with the Pro version next.
And now we're off with the new and improved JCC fitting, the ToughLED Pro.
Okay, the clips now hold out of the way, so you see they're a lot firmer. Lift out my tray. Now, some other really clever things I could have done with the wiring loom in this one. I was trying to keep this as fast as I can. You know, I am rapid gas at the end of the day, so I kept those in position. Drill out the four fixing holes in the back that are already laid out in the form of a BESA box for me.
That's great. So there's no tracing, no measuring. You've just drilled the pre-guided holes.
Yeah, I have. Yeah, a little hole for my conductor to come through, and then I've just got to find those four M4 screws into position. I'm going to do one at each end to hold the fitting up, and then go back and put the other two in and tighten off.
Yeah, and we can really see that those clips are staying up and out of the way now, aren't they? It wasn't just gravity holding them down on the bench earlier, they're actually supported well out of reach.
Once I've got this tightened down, I can connect up. So just a case of making those connections, you can see how much simpler it is when it fits the BESA box with the holes already laid out for you. In go my tray clips.
Very good. And again, we're seeing there, this is another key difference, isn't it? That the fitting, the tray and the lid are actually all combined into one thing. So we're going to see in a minute how helpful that is.
Yep. Connections again are super easy. I've got one of four positions I could have clipped this into. The cable reaches all four of those. Hook back. I'm just ready now to position my tray into place once I make sure everything's tucked in.
That's great, isn't it? So those clips aren't in your way. And again, that combined tray and lid just going together and those clips just snapping into place. They weren't in your way at all, were they?
I'm trying to make a more logical approach to clipping them in after your feedback on the first run.
There we go.
So just two more to go, and I think I'll be eating that cake in a minute.
My goodness, well, that felt a lot quicker than the previous one. Let's see the time. Wow, that was fast.
Well, as you said there, I don't think I've left smug mode because I won the race.
Interesting, you also lost the race, Gary, but I think it's fair to say that the real star of that was this light fitting from JCC. So let's look at some of the really brilliant details.
Where would you like to start?
Well, let's start off with the number of different fixing methods that you've got here. So we can surface mount it if we want.
Yep.
We can either do that by drilling straight through the back, or we can use this clever mounting bracket, which is nice and wide and chunky and is not going to kind of flex and distort on the ceiling. And once that's installed, it will actually allow you to clip that on the back, and then it'll allow the fitting to slide up and down on there once you've got that installed and get it into its final resting place. So that's perfect if perhaps you're screwing onto a plasterboard ceiling where you're struggling to find the joists or similar.
Okay, and you can also hang it from there as well, can you?
Yeah, so we've got this clip here that goes on the back. I've got one here that I prepared earlier, and you can see there that that then turns that into a fitting that we can hang from chain if we wanted to.
Okay, so it's got all those points covered, and talking of points, entry points, I'm seeing three on this side for conduits, three on the other side and two on the end, as well as the three on the back. That's got you pretty covered, isn't it?
Absolutely, so you can bring your conduit in any of those areas. In here, we could just drill the hole out in the back and bring the cable straight through if we wanted to, or we can mount it on the BESA box, as we've discussed already. And it's very clever, the entry holes on the side here have been designed in such a way that when the conduit comes in, it won't distort the fitting or distort the conduit, making your installation a lot easier as well.
And if you were surface wiring, the tendency is to maybe use a stuffing gland, which they provide you with, maybe wiring in the end and out the other end.
That's it, so either coming in the side with that or coming in the ends with it if you're using a non-conduit installation method.
Okay, now I'm thinking about the IP rating of the fitting, and this clever little bit of kit down here allows me to keep that IP rating, doesn't it?
Indeed it does. So what JCC have found electricians tend to do, I find this hard to believe myself, but they drill out a hole in the back, bring the cables through, and then they flood that little hole with silicon in order to try and maintain the IP rating. Now that's not super reliable, to be fair. And so what they've done is they've created this clever little sealant here, this little grommet. And what happens is that you can pierce that hole, bring your cables through, that sits inside that molded section, and then this part goes on over that and actually just clips into place. You give it a twist and it clips in, seals that up around the cable, and you've maintained the IP rating with a proprietary device rather than a little bit of silicone.
Okay, I'm looking at it now. We've actually got the light fin itself disconnected from the back plate, which is really clever because of the amount of positions I can actually have the connector in, isn't it? So the connector is disconnected there. How many positions are there?
So there are four different positions that that can go in. So you can either put it at the end, towards the middle, and then symmetrically going out the other way. So again, it doesn't matter where you bring your cables in, they're pretty much always going to be able to reach that block. And actually, this can completely disconnect from the tray there, so you can take that out completely, remove the earth connection with that spade crimp, and that means that you don't even have this dangling in your way while you're trying to put it all together, while you're trying to install your cables into the push fit connection, which is still super easy.
So making that very easy for that second fix process, leaving part of the fitting away, which is great. And the cables themselves can obviously go under here as well to support them out of the way, making yet another tidy installation there.
What a bit of kit. That's really good so far, isn't it? Really exciting.
Great features, got everything covered. They've listened to electricians. That's what JCC do, obviously, when they're doing their design process. And you could tell from the time difference, can't you, how much quicker it was to install the Pro version.
Indeed. And it doesn't stop there, because we've got this clever feature as well, where we saw it demonstrated in the video. The clips here stay up and out of the way. They've got that rounded top so that you don't get your knuckles bloodied when you're bringing that off there. And actually, you may notice on my knuckles it's healed up a little bit more. I actually did do my knuckles on some clips on another fitting.
Oh yeah, that is smooth. And there's also the ability to put a security screw in there, isn't there, for say tamper proofing as well, isn't there?
It doesn't end there, because another problem that we tend to have with this kind of strip light is the situation where you've got different variants of it. So perhaps you want it in emergency, perhaps you want it with a microwave sensor, some kind of movement sensor. Again, you've got to order all the different variants, and that can get a little bit complicated. It's easy to get lost in your ordering system. Well, here we've got one fitting, and then you order the attachments for it. So this one here clips into place inside the fitting, and you can see, if we just look over here, Gary, you can see that there's actually a space ready made to receive that, and it just clips into place. You slightly change the connections down here at this end, and then basically you're away, that's installed.
And the best type of light to save energy is one that's turned off. So the microwave sensor, especially at the moment with energy prices being rocket high, what a fantastic bit of kit. And that just clips in as well, doesn't it?
That's clips in as well. That's got its own little position as well, further down the fitting, all the way down at the end there. So that just goes into place and pokes through that little slot so that it can access the wider world. And what's really clever is you can turn it into emergency or microwave sensor, or both.
Wow, what else can you put into a light fin? If you want to see other great light fins that JCC make, check out the video over there.